Hey, if you want to sell projects to multifamily owners, you need to think like a multifamily owner. I'm helping Chris here, and I want you to understand the cost on this project. Now, to a multifamily owner, all they care about is what they can do to raise rent. So the thing they care about most is interior repairs. So that's going to be your kitchen, that's going to be your countertops, your backsplash, your flooring. And on this property, we have a budget of $2,000 per property. Now, how far you can get that to spread, that really kind of determines how much you can increase the spread of profit on the job. Now the roof here is about $500,000. We've got paint at $50,000, siding $42,000. You may think all these repairs with the landscaping, the pool, the interior, the siding, the paint, the roof, there's almost close to $1 million in improvements. Where does that money come from? Well, this property is worth $11 million. We have 100 units. We increased the property 30% in value by raising the rents 30%. The money that we invest, this $2 million plus $1 million, whenever we pay off the loan, we're able to actually double that and to turn it into $6 million. And so it's leveraging the bank, it's making the property worth the money. And would you pay $1,200 a month for this?
Eventually, yes.
All right, cool. Well, let me show you around a little bit about what it means. When you go to a multifamily property owner, they only care about, you know, the things they care about. You have to find their biggest concern. You know, with Ben, you know, it's all about the ability to, you know, really stand out, to add value. And so that's why, you know, if he's gonna do a bunch of money in interior repairs, that's his most important thing. But if he has a bad roof and the roof starts to leak on his new interior repairs, what happens?
He loses money.
He loses money. So now he cares about the roof. And so you gotta realize you're gonna get multiple bids. You gotta have your supplier. You have to have three different suppliers. You have to bid them all against each other. And then you have to have a crew and you have to tell them this is a commercial job and you have to cut the price a little bit. And on a project like this, you may not get the margins that you get in insurance. As a matter of fact, you may work for half of the margins that you're used to, but you know you're getting paid. You know you have multiple projects, and if you do it the right way, you know you can add value, beat other people, and still make 25%, okay? Let me show you around. Hey, the thing about multifamily investing is that, dude, if you don't have experience, then people won't take your offers. Bank won't take you serious. And there is high competition when there's a lot of value to add. So I showed you about the previous owners and how it was just next door and their plans were just to build another tower here. Well, this thing went out to bid when it went on the market and a lot of people went after the deal. And the thing about Ben is, you know, he got trained by the best, Grant Cardone, and he has got a lot of experience in keeping the contracting cost down. Here we're doing a pool resurfacing, and you know, he's as a contractor, and how he's able to ever even get lower bids for roofing. I know that he never overpays for a single service, and he gets the best quality vendors. And so this pool is gonna make it better for everyone that lives here. But you know, the real idea is that new ownership is bad, that maybe these people think that the way it was before was better, but there's no possible way. You know, the interior units are getting redone, the air conditioning's getting fixed up, the pool's getting improved upon. So, you know, a small increase in rents, that's understandable. And for a lot of people, they would appreciate this type of improvement. And so this is what I love most about multifamily investing, is you can provide a better quality home for kids, a better quality place to play by the pool. And you know, these people, they have a great property and now they can really, really feel like that they have a more classy, secure, and beautiful property to call their home. I want to say the most unique thing about this property, whenever you try to invest in a property, you know, the idea is that there's a lot of jobs coming up, that there's a lot of opportunity for growth in the area, and that there's something unique about the property that, you know, and the deal is like you never overpay for real estate, but on a property that you can add value like this. See, you know, we really acquired this property for the same price as maybe a non-waterfront property. And to me, this was the biggest unique value of this property. Not very many apartment complexes in this area available on the water. And for me, you know, it's a better quality of life to be able to take your kids fishing, or if you're a grandparent, to be able to take your kids out on the dock. You know, I can remember the days growing up with my grandpa and grandma and sitting out with them fishing on a dock just like this. And so you might think, well, yeah, I would pay an extra $100, $200 a month versus another property for something like this. So as an investor, I knew that this property really had potential because, you know, like I said, at $800 a month rent, there's so many other lesser properties. And yeah, the interior units need some fixing up, and we're gonna show you what that looks like. But the grounds of this place are beautiful. And this tells me that a different type of renter, a different type of maybe even a college student are gonna be more likely to move in here when we fix this property up.